This is the Tilt Overdrive by REVV Amplification, and it is Shawn Tubbs' signature overdrive. And if I was Shawn, I'd be pretty darn proud of this. Shawn Tubbs is a very handsome and very tasteful musician who makes some excellent demos on YouTube. I'll leave the link to his YouTube channel in the description box. And REVV Amplification, of course, are probably Canada's premium amplifier brand, and they're well known all over the world. And they only build quality stuff. So between them, you can't go wrong, really, and they've come up with a really wicked overdrive pedal. This is a Charvel San Dimas Select. It's got a Damasio super distortion in the back, so reasonably hot humbucker, and a couple of HS6s Strat pickups. And I'm running today through, as I normally do, four different types of amplifiers so I can show you what the Tilt Overdrive is all about. The first amp that you just heard was a little Princeton model. In the XFX 3 behind me over here, this lets me dial up pretty much anything I want to try and appease everybody who's watching. All right, the Tilt Overdrive. We have two components, as you can see. We've got the drive side, which features volume, gain, treble and bass. And over here is the tilt section, and it's a tilt boost, which means the EQ can be tilted, kind of like a seesaw, bottom end more, top end less, top end more, bottom end less. And that's how the tilt basically works. And as well as that, you've got a high pass switch which will let you cut either half of the low end or all of the low end, and it has a myriad of different uses. So first of all, let's have a look at this drive section. All right, I'll go to the back pickup, turn him off. Very dynamic, as you can hear when I turn this volume knob down, it cleans up. And a lot of people like me, old school players, are into the cleaning up thing when you turn the volume knob down. This overdrive will let you do it. The treble control over here will add treble a nice amount of bite. So it's kind of usable all the way through its entire range. Here it is completely anti-clockwise. I kind of like it where Shawn's favourite position is, which is around 11 to 12 o'clock. Bass, we'll add bass. More of a low mids control. So it's not actually all that flubby bass that, you know, becomes unusable when you wind it all the way up. It's a nice low mids, and coupled with this excellently voiced treble control. Beautiful. Gain wise, we've got from a little up to full tilt. It's It's an overdrive for the masses, people. Let's go to those really clean. Actually, I'll just go to the second position kind of split coil thing here. So nice and smooth, but... That's the drive section. Before it, and independently, if you wish, is the boost section. Now, with this guy at about 9 o'clock and this guy at about 3 o'clock, it's kind of neutral, right? So you see what happens when I wind it anti-clockwise, the tilt knob, that is. We are going to get the, they call it tilt? He calls it, yeah, tilt EQ. You get more bass if you wind it this way, all clockwise. And the reverse effect, less bass and more top end if you wind it counterclockwise, but the neutral spot is about here. Now, if your sound is too flubby, you can use the high cut switch to either go upwards, which will cut about half the bass, so normal, and down all the way. So it really tightens up the bass. Now, if I go to an amp like a Plexi 50 here. I can use this guy to boost it even more. Or tighten it up with this high cut switch. If I go back to the Princeton, wind this down a little bit, and I've got my drive dialed in. I can use this guy as like a solo boost. And then dial the amount of high cut that I wish, you know, in on top. So that's got a bit too much bass for me, so I'm going to go this way. But alternatively, I can use the tilt control to wind out bass and kind of add treble. That's the other thing. I can use it just to push the front of the amp itself. And, of course, it's an amp model, but same diff. So lots of boost, say, back pickup. Now, that's pretty flubby, so I'm going to use the high cut, and I'm going to wind this guy back a bit. Great. Neck pickup. Back him off a bit. Put that bass back in. Now, if I go to something like a high watt, you know, with a muff in front of it and some delay. A la David Gilmour, I can use this boost to drive that muff even further into the stratosphere. Actually, you know what? I'm going to use a Strat for this bit. All right, I have a Strat. It's a bit more kind of, you know, to point. boost is really tightening up the bottom end, and you can feel it under your fingers. I'm not sure if you can hear it, but you can sure feel it. Effectively, you could use, I'll just turn that drive off, the muff off, and this is what our amp sounds like without the muff or the boost. Gee, that's a lot of delay. I didn't realise I had that many repeats dialed in. Shawn Tubbs. Congratulations, mate. That's an absolute ripper. I wish I could play half as well as you to demonstrate it with some taste. But I play like me. I hope I've conveyed to you the idea that this is an exceptional pedal with all sorts of different applications with different guitars and different amplifiers. It's really good. The Tilt Overdrive from REVV and Shawn Tubbs. What am I going to go out on? Oh, here's an AC30. So it works with an AC30 as well. Oh, one other trick. If you hold this drive foot switch down when you're turning it on, it'll turn on the drive and the boost at once. And you can also program it that when you power up, it will turn one or the other or both on for people, you know, with big pedal boards and MIDI controls. They've thought of everything. It's a ripper. The Tilt. See you soon.